Hi, my name is David Riddle, and this is my business partner, Dan Seifer. We're the founders, inventors, and designers of the Infinite Environments audio system, and we are going to give you a little tour of the various components that are contained within this unique sonic environment. First of all, what you're looking at right here is what's called an infinite line array. The reason that it is called an infinite line array is because it goes from the top of the ceiling to the bottom of the floor. It's a very important component, and this is why no one ever in audio has ever built one of these systems, because you cannot sell the speaker. You have to sell the speaker as an integrated component of the room. The room forms the loudspeaker. We are inside of a fully engineered loudspeaker, and through the use of ultra-precision manufacturing techniques, your proprietary design of all of these drivers, no one else has built anything even close to this. Not only do we have 7 of these 10-foot high line arrays with 128 elements in each one, all under digital signal processing control, we also have, this is one of 7, and this is one of 4, a total of 32 subwoofers with 20,000 watts of power to those subwoofers. And this is the only room in history that goes down to 8 cycles. And it can produce sound levels up to 136 dB SBL. What that means is when you have 18 square feet of woofer surface powered by 20,000 watts, it definitely can shake every aspect of your physical body.
So I wanted to just interject, circling back to the line array and how important this is. Two aspects of it are very, very important. When you have a truncated line, floor to ceiling, it behaves as if it were infinitely long. And what that means is nothing is reflected off of the ceiling. Normally, any point source speaker, you have reflections off of every internal surface.
A point source speaker is a traditional loudspeaker.
Traditional loudspeaker. No reflections off the ceiling, no reflections off the floor. Because this speaker is mounted in the wall, completely flush, no reflections off of this wall either. So 3 primary sources of reflected sound, and reflected sound is always colored sound. It's never returned in perfect fidelity. It's extremely difficult to do. We've done our best here, but it is very difficult to do. So by eliminating those 3 reflected surfaces, the localization of sound is superb, even though the speaker cannot be identified as a speaker from within the room. You hear sound coming from here, but you don't hear a point source speaker.
You don't hear, it doesn't sound when you're listening to program material in here, whether it be music or voice or accompanying movies. You do not perceive as a sound coming from a speaker at all.
Never.
What you perceive is you're enveloped within this sound field. And most people's immediate impression is they've never experienced that kind of intimacy with a program material. But the other thing is that all of this hardware, we engineered and designed every transducer from scratch. These are not anybody else's transducer. These are ours. We design them with our own special test equipment and our own test hardware that no one else has access to. We have a world-class transducer laboratory to do that. Now, if you look here, you'll see right here, we see a solid, like a flexible wall. This is one of the modular absorbers, okay? This is a reflector. These are diffusers. These specifically are placed in this point in the room because the sound coming from these speakers, we don't want to bounce off this room and give a secondary path to the listener.
Straight to the listener, right. This diffuses it so that it has no point source here either.
And these are all unequal depth slotted diffusers so that they basically encompass the entire frequency spectrum of diffusion. So it spreads equally all frequencies into the room, okay? Then we have here is another absorber panel, and these are all modular panels. Absorber, 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 large reflector, because this large reflector provides a means to enhance the envelopment of the sound as it comes down this wall and comes and bounces off. So
Well, the other primary purpose of this particular reflector is we have a speaker like this on this wall, and that comes over here and comes here and bounces a little bit forward, and the same thing with that one. So it's like adding two additional channels.
Right, exactly. And so when we started designing this room, the first thing we did was we covered all the walls with solid surface.
Gypsum board or whatever.
And wall board, and we put one center loudspeaker, and we started from there. And we started doing our complex instrumentation using a 5-microphone array with automatic switcher and a fast Fourier transform analyzer. And we were able to look at all the problems in the room. And then the way we just started designing the acoustic treatments in the room, which are specifically diffusers, absorbers, and reflectors, is by individually taking a tall roll-around rack with various absorbent materials and moving them around in the room and doing a multiplicity of tests as we did that. So basically, we started from nothing when we had a single speaker, and we started analyzing a very, very characteristics of this specific room using very objective test techniques.
So another advantage of this design technique, if you cover this entire wall, all the walls, with an acoustically transparent cloth, you can put any pattern, any color, any design element you want into this room, and the speakers simply disappear, completely gone, because it's in the wall, not on the wall. You don't have any warts sticking out, no scar tissue from speakers.
And we have that luxury because of the fact we're not selling equipment. We're not shipping equipment to a location and they install it. No, we are arriving on site and building this entire structure, room. Everything's been engineered. I built a tapper that tapped every single wall section, okay? And we would put an accelerometer. We had a digital tapper that would be signaled by the FFT analyzer. It would tap the wall. We had an accelerometer which measured the vibration analysis of the wall. We would produce a waterfall plot. Then we individually laminated each stud bay. If you notice, these are all equal 16-inch stud bays. Each stud bay was individually analyzed for its vibrational analysis. And then we individually laminated with various types of mastic and wallboard to get a characteristic cue and a characteristic resonant point. And the idea is, nobody's ever done this before in the history of sound. Nobody's ever gone to this much trouble to design every aspect. And not only that, these walls are actually flexible. They're designed to be lossy. That means they take the low frequency, the long 50 plus feet long waves of low frequency audio, and they cause this room to expand and contract, to absorb and to make the room lossy for low frequencies.
Well, at the resonant points, yes.
Yes, and so
acoustic resonant. And
the point is that the ceiling at 10 hertz at 120 dB SPL, that ceiling moves up and down an inch and a half because we wanted it to be diaphragmatic, to be lossy. No one's ever done this. Everybody else, all other sound systems ever on this planet were simply a compilation of various components placed into various rooms and then band-aid fixes trying to solve the problems. We inverted that equation. We're no longer putting various speakers into various rooms and trying to ameliorate all the acoustic issues. We basically put people inside, like I said earlier, an engineered loudspeaker.
But wait, there's more.
Yes.
I have one more feature. This is mostly for people doing a home installation. I told you, you can cover the walls with whatever treatment you want as long as it's acoustically transparent and it will not interfere in any way with your architecture or your design. Another feature, the same phenomenon where you can stand this close and the speaker still sounds like it's 10 feet away, you can have furnishings right here in front of the speaker. No one in the room will know or hear any difference. If you were listening to it right now, I could stand right here, you wouldn't hear any difference.
In other words, if the sound was playing and you're listening to this, so, and when I walk in front of it, nothing changes.
Right.
And that's because we're no longer producing a conical wavefront. we're producing a cylindrical wavefront that basically has an equal pressure zone, and it flows around the fixtures within the room.
Right. So these are all benefits for home installations, because everybody wants a beautiful home theater with decorations. Maybe they want chandeliers, I don't know. Whatever it is, this system will not interfere with any of that, and those items will not interfere with the quality of the sound that you get.
Really, the only non-engineered items in this room are the carpeting and the screws that hold it together. Every single piece of wood was engineered, it was tested, it was installed, glued, screwed, and all of the joints have elastomeric isolation between all of the connections within the room. Nothing was left to chance. We used our more than 120 years of combined engineering experience to design this room. Both myself, Dave Riddle, Dan Seifert, and our other business partner, Marshall Buck, who is also a PhD in psychoacoustics and a past president of the Audio Engineering Society. So we have credentials of untold numbers of individual loudspeakers and other components within the audio recording and playback system design changes we've made over our whole careers, all invested in this room. And in reality, it is sort of the culmination of all of our expertise in all these various areas to build these rooms. I mean, if you look at those subwoofers, the subwoofers are of custom design. Even the way the subwoofers are contained and mounted in the cabinet are totally different from anybody else's subwoofer. We don't use regular fasteners to hold them in like every other loudspeaker manufacturer. We actually use an elastomeric steel-backed ring to hold 1,000 pounds per square inch to keep those woofers totally immobilized within the cabinet. In addition, Danny can extol the additional virtues of the subwoofers right there, because of their, you'll notice that there you'll see cones and magnets and cones and magnets. Those are actually to eliminate second harmonic distortion caused by nonlinearities in the suspension system.
Right.
And in addition, the fact that they're horizontally opposed like this, it cancels the Newtonian mass. If you ever go up to any other subwoofer on the planet and you put your hands on that cabinet is vibrating. And guess what that vibration does? It contaminates the sound that subwoofer is putting out.
It muddies it up.
It adds tremendous distortion to it. This, if you put your hand on this wall and you're feeling the wall physically move, but you put your hand here, this wall's moving in and out, you put your hand on this cabinet, it's totally not moving. No vibration whatsoever. It's the only subwoofer ever made that does this. And this is a totally unique design. Everything in this room is a totally unique design and really needs, doesn't matter what I say, until you walk into this room and you experience what unlimited resources and unlimited money can do, you can generate a room like this. If you have the expertise that we three have, and we've acquired that knowledge over our entire lifetime,
here it is.
And this really is until you experience, again, like I said before, whatever I say doesn't make any sense to you, but maybe not. All I can tell you is once you experience it, you will never be happy with a sound system ever again in your life. Once you experience infinite environments, it is so powerfully different from anything you've ever experienced. And especially when people hear music they've listened to their entire lifetime, and they literally say to me, you know what you've done? All the music I ever listened to in my life was locked in a cage. You've unlocked the cage. I'm hearing music like I've never heard it before. I'm hearing parts of instruments and the timbre of the instruments that I've never heard. And the reason for that is the tremendous distortion that a typical loudspeaker introduces, and it introduces it for a multiplicity of reasons. But we essentially, from all of our expertise in designing loudspeakers over all of these years, I designed my first loudspeaker when I was 14. I don't know how old Danny was, but I can assure you, I had no idea what I was doing originally, but having this collection of the greatest minds in audio put in the same room with unlimited resources. We had unlimited money, unlimited time, and unlimited expertise. And when you put all those three things together, you generate something that heretofore has never existed. And when you experience it, I guarantee you, you'll walk out of that door with your jaw on the ground because you know you've never really heard reproduced sound ever in your life until you hear an infinite environment.
You should see just outside the door, the skid marks are amazing.